Come on, Gian.
Oops, oops.
Let go!
Hey, hey, just you're not minute. Going anywhere.
See her, okay?
Where do you think you're going, huh?
Where are your manners? Keep on playing your guitar. Go on.
Hey, you know the song, Adopt a Little Boy?
What? You don't know?
He's making fun of you, man. Of course he knows that song.
If he doesn't know, we can sing it for him. It's as easy as that, man.
That's right.
Good idea, man.
Here, all together now.
Am I right?
Okay,
all right. One, two.
This is for you.
Three.
Adopt a little boy. Oh, Mr. Mayor. Adopt. Oh, please adopt him. And make him your pet.
Nice.
Let's go. That was great. Oops, oops. Did you like our version?
Stop it.
Huh?
And don't bully us. We are not afraid of you.
You know, you're so...
Hey, let him go.
He's a fighter.
Let go of my
dad. You're not supposed to be part of this, but you keep sticking your nose in.
Get back to me.
Give that back. Give that back.
Give that back.
Give that back.
Hey, hey, hey. Hey, shoot. Catch
him. Let me shoot.
Okay,
I'm over here,
you jerks!
Come on!
Hey, give it to him! Give it to him!
Wait, wait, wait! Whoa! That's come on, man!
Come on!
Hey!
Over here!
Stop it!
Get it right here!
I said give it back! Give it back to me now! What now?
Here, you can have my gym shoes.
Thank you. Hope you don't mind. This is my only pair of shoes. Let's hurry. I don't want to be late for class. I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. It's nothing.
See that?
Oh, my God.
What's that over there?
What are these guys laughing at?
It's a shoe.
That belongs to
you. That's what's it doing up there anyway?
Shello.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Isn't that your shoe?
Oh my gosh.
Wait here.
This is
I'll get the janitor to help us.
Oh my gosh, whose shoes are up on the flagpole?
Oh my gosh, if that was mine, I'd just leave it up there.
Yeah, how embarrassing. Oh my gosh, you're right. It's not even stylish.
I'll bet it
it's about time she replaces it.
Shello, I think you better get your shoe.
It's starting to stink.
And we can't do a flag ceremony with that there.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Come on, aren't you getting your shoe?
That's so embarrassing.
What do you want?
Oh, oh. Oh, come on.
She's actually trying to get the shoe for her.
Oh, my goodness.
Let him go on the flagpole.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh.
Stop him.
So cute.
Oh, my goodness.
Do you know what he is doing?
He's
trying
to be your hero.
Oh, my
mom.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness.
Well, can you believe
that?
He did.
Who's that, man?
I can't believe it. He's so cute.
I wonder if he's cute.
Oh my goodness. I wish he could do something like that for me, too.
He is. What a gentleman.
Oh, so cute.
Oh my goodness.
I look over here.
He looks for
me. Oh my goodness. Oh, he's cute. He's so
hello, Gordon. Is this yours?
He's handsome. Over here.
He's a
meeker.
He's
handsome. Come here, gorgeous.
Hey,
hey, hey. P-O-P, pop-pop girls, pop-pop girls.
Hi, I'm Brittany. I'm 15 years old. I come from Monte Grasso. I'm 32, 24, 34. I can act, I can sing, I can dance. I'm a cheerleader. My hobbies are texting and talking on the phone. Oh my gosh, I believe that children are the future. They should well let them lead the way. Words of thought from our national hero, Jose Rizal.
Carry her shoe.
What's your name?
Lawrence. Lawrence Trinidad.
Trinidad? Who the hell? That's the same as our mayor's name. That's right. Are you related?
Oh my gosh! You're Lawrence Trinidad? You're next in line, the one and only heir to the throne of all his riches. You're his one and only son. That's why you're so cute. And you were so brave. Oh my gosh. Goodness, you really took after your father. You're my hero. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Wait,
weren't you studying in the States? Are you moving here?
Yeah.
Are you studying here?
Yes.
Does this mean I'll be seeing you
Lawrence?
Every day?
Oh, Gian. When did you arrive? Just now. I went straight here.
You mean to tell me you haven't gone home? Then let's go. Uncle Ernesto and Aunt Frida will be happy to see you. I'm sure they'll be surprised.
Wait.
Have you seen Shello? She was just here. Brittany, where's Shello?
Why are you asking us? Excuse me. I don't have friends with worn-out shoes. As if.
Come on.
Lawrence, you're leaving without even saying goodbye?
Bye.
Bye, Lawrence! See you soon! So cute!
Get over him!
Sweetheart, you've been working all day long at the town hall. And when you come home, do you still have to think of work? Isn't that too much? You know, you're tiring yourself out. You really need to rest. I know. Why don't we go to the beach this weekend? We haven't done that for a long time. You'll be able to relax there, right?
I want to finish my work as soon as possible. And then maybe we can take a longer vacation. In America. Where your son is. I want to spend more time with him. I want to iron things out with him once and for all. I don't like this feeling.
Ernesto, don't worry about that anymore. I promise you, I will do everything I can to set things straight between you two. Okay? I promise you. You know, eventually he will realize how much we love him. And then he will come back to us. I love you.
Hello. Is Mrs. Reyes there? She isn't. I just want to know if Guadalupe Garcia happened to drop by for a visit or something. Rita. Rita Montegracia is her screen name. Ah, is that so? Nobody's seen her for a long time. Are you sure, ma'am? No, I was just thinking maybe she did. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Father?
Oh, Shella. Oh dear, your shoes. They really weren't out after all. It's time to buy you a new pair.
It's okay, Father. I can still fix those.
Lawrence, why didn't you phone us when you were coming home? We could have picked you up instead of renting that car.
It's okay. This is better. Surprise.
Well, yeah, you surprised me. We all thought you left for good. But wait, why did you come home? It's all so sudden.
Jian, do I need a reason?
Well, no. But I have a hunch why you decided to come back. It's like this. You came from the airport, and you went straight here. To our school. Instead of going home. It only means one thing. The person you want to see is just around here. And you know what? I think I know who that person is. You want me to tell you?
You know what? Stop it. Come on, take me on a tour of my new school. Let's go.
Lawrence, wait, can we do this tomorrow?
No, we can't, Jian. Because when I come here tomorrow, I want to be familiar with the entire place, okay? So, come on.
Okay, give me a second.
Doming, just a second.
Yes, sir. Sir Essing, I thought we were going to save that money for all our bills. That's just enough for the film rental and the electricity.
Don't worry, we'll get it back, Doming. I really need it.
Okay.
I don't understand, Mr. Tan. He waited until it was already too late to call for a meeting. Everyone's supposed to be resting.
Never mind, sweetheart. I'm sure it's a short meeting anyway. Besides, Mr. Tan is one of your biggest contributors, especially during the last elections, right?
Yes, yes.
Oh, Ernesto.
What?
Your son.
Huh?
It's Lawrence.
Lawrence, you don't know how glad I am to see you back. I just knew it. I knew that sooner or later, you will realize where you're supposed to belong. It's here with your family. Here in Monte Grasha. Son, I'm so happy.
That's enough. It's useless to mend them.
Those shoes are hopeless. You should already buy a new pair.
I can't yet. We have no money. Besides, these are still fine.
Fine? How can you say they're still fine?
They're still fine? Or is there another reason why you hold on to that pair?
Nope, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Lawrence?
Now that our son is back home, I promise to be a good father to him. I am aware of my shortcomings, Frida. I'm impatient. I can be hot-headed. But this time, I will try to understand him. I will do my best to let him feel how much we love and value him in our lives. Things will be like they used to be. We will be one happy family.
Father?
Hmm.
You bought me a new pair of shoes?
Of course. Well, I felt sorry for your old shoes. It's about time you replace them. The movie house made a little money, so I bought a pair.
Thank you. But Father, where's my old pair?
I threw it away. They're useless now.
What?
I don't understand. Wait, Shello. What is this? Don't tell me you still plan to wear that old pair to school. Don't you like the new ones I bought you?
No, I like it. But I still want to keep this old pair.
Why?
Nothing really. Maybe I'm just being sentimental, I think. I just value it because it was you and Mother who gave them to me.
Oh, my dear child. Mwah. Okay, then. Eat your breakfast and then go to school.
Yes, sir.
I don't understand why you keep staying in this cramped room, Lawrence. Are you sure you don't want to go back to your own room?
Mother, I like it here. And I prefer to share a room with someone.
My son is such a handsome boy. I bet all the girls in your old school were always trying to get your attention. But remember, Lawrence, I don't want you having girlfriends. Your father and I still have a lot of plans for you.
Yes.
You were the one who decided to come back. And whether you like it or not, this is still your father's house. So you have to treat him with respect. Don't fight with him anymore. You'll just end up hurting each other. Lawrence, I'm asking you, please. Please try to get along with him. He's doing his best. Do it for me, okay?
Well, okay. But no promises. I'll try.
That's good enough for me, son, okay?
I'm going to be late, Mother. I have to go. Gian's waiting for me. So, I'll see you.
Okay, take care.
Thank you.
Lawrence? Gian?
What are you doing here?
Nothing. I just thought of passing by. You know, to check your transfer papers as well as, inspect your new school.
Oh, I'm afraid the mayor's being humble again. Lawrence, the reason why your father's here is because he's finalizing his personal donation of 20 computers for this school. In all my years here in Monte Gracia, your father is the most generous mayor of all.
That's not entirely true. I have to admit my own personal reasons. One of which is, of course, I'd like the best school for Lawrence and Gian. So whatever I can do to help out, I'm taking the initiative.
Father, we're both running late. We need to go.
Oh, sure. So, ma'am.
All right, then.
Just wait for the computers.
Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor.
And, I'll try my best to get a bigger budget next year. I know our public
bigger
school sure
budget.
Needs a lot.
Oh. Thank you, Mayor. You're so kind.
Okay, you too. Aim high and study very hard. Don't give your principal a headache. Make me proud, son.
Lawrence, he's a great man. And you must be very lucky to have a father like him.
Thank you. But we really have to go. Come on, Gian.
All right. Go ahead.
See you.
Take care.
Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor.
For me to go as well.
Oh, yes.
What's
Thank
with
you.
The face?
Okay.
I was a bit taken aback. I was expecting to see someone else today, and it wasn't my father. Come on, Gian. Let's go find that person.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
That girl is here.
I can just stop this. I can't really find time to do anything.
Oh, yeah. Here. Girls, I had my hair done. Do you think Lawrence will like my new highlights? Look,
of course. You suit you very well. Your blue highlights accentuate your rosy cheeks. They're just perfect.
And wait, what should I use? My new pink lipstick or the orange one?
I think pink. Wait a second. Orange. Or use both.
Yeah, right. Oh, and by the way, girls, look at my new shoes. They're new. My father bought them from Hong Kong. They're very expensive. And like other people, they buy new, but the cheap kind. I'm sure my Lawrence will like this better.
You want me to put that back into the flagpole?
Your Lawrence?
Yes. You have a problem with that?
Me?
Yeah.
Nothing.
Wow. You've got some nerve trying to annoy me. Let's just wait and see when Lawrence gets here. I'm the one who's going to grab his attention because I have taste.
Right.
And like you, look. An old blouse, an old skirt.
Yeah.
And isn't even bother with your hair.
Proud.
You don't put on makeup. A cheap cologne. And no accessories whatsoever. Pity.
<Yeah.
laughs> And overall, you may have new shoes for now, but out of fashion. You're cheap. No class. You're such an eyesore. Lawrence will never notice you in a million years. It will take a miracle.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm not trying to be noticed. Besides, you're the one he'll look at when he comes because of your exciting look. What is that, Christmas tree theme?
What?
Whoa.
Hey, Brittany.
Yeah. Be careful with her. She might hit you with her shoes. That's
awesome. You're right.
I think Tomboy's got new shoes.
Right. I know.
At least this time, when she throws them, I'd be putting new ones on the flagpole. Unlike the one yesterday. stunk like skunk.
Stinky. Oh, my God.
What the?
How's my hair? Oh, my God. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. You're so cute, Lawrence. I love you. Take me out on a date, please.
We prepared something for you. Let's go, girls. 1, 2, 3.
Give me an L. Give me a T. Lawrence C. Welcome to Monte Grasha High.
Thank you.
Lawrence, don't be so cheap. It's so opposite and much prettier than this cello. Huh. Let's go, girls. If he doesn't like me, it's a slot.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That's so mad. Mm-hmm.
Why don't you just stick to your fans?
Cello, you've got new shoes. They're nice.
Move it.
Hey. Did I say anything wrong?
Mm-mm. What are you looking at?
We're here. Slow down. Ouch.
Okay, set it down.
That hurt.
And then, we went to the theater, where Father's bodyguards chased us. You see this? As long as our hands are imprinted here, we will always remain friends. And whoever will break this pact will turn to stone. Jian?
Hmm?
Remember the last time you saw me at the cemetery?
Mm-hmm.
When I had that bruise on the face? I told you I got into a fight. But that wasn't true. Actually, the truth was, Cello punched me.
I know. She already told me. But don't worry, Lawrence. It's all right.
She
because
told
she
you?
Also hurt her hand with the punch he gave you. But the thing is, she was really mad.
Well, I really can't blame her. Because I told her that I've already forgotten our promises to one another. I told her I've forgotten her. But you know, Jian, the truth is, there's no way in the world I could ever forget Cello. Forget her? How could I? I mean, the both of you. You were the ones who remained my loyal friends, you were true to me. And I know you'd never keep secrets from me. Because I know, if ever I find out what your secret is, you know that I'd feel bad. You wouldn't do that to me. Jian? You and Shell are the only ones I trust. You've always been honest to me. But what did I do to you when I came back here? I pushed you both away. This is why I'm back. That's why I returned. Because I wanted to mend our broken friendship. my friendship with Shallow. I need to ask her for her forgiveness.
Lawrence? Why do you say that only Shallow and I are true to you? There's Uncle Ernesto, Aunt Frida. I'm sure they both love you. And they wouldn't do anything bad to hurt you or put you in trouble, right?
Anyway, just help me. Because I feel that no matter what I do, Shallow will always resent me. So, Jian, help me, okay?
I'll handle this, Lawrence.
Father.
Shallow. Good evening. Seems like my beautiful daughter's sad, so what's the matter?
Father, I just want to ask, do those flyers really help in getting people to this theater?
Of course. I handed out flyers all day. Just like these. Look outside. A lot of people are watching. That's why we need to make more. I'll hand them out tomorrow, so we can win more customers.
Don't worry, Father. From now on, I'll find the time to help you hand out those flyers.
Thanks, dear. You can start now. Just kidding. You could come back tomorrow. We're really sorry.
What's wrong with you guys?
I'm so disgusted with your service.
Can't believe it.
You could come back.
There's no time.
We promise by tomorrow. We'll be back tomorrow. Come back tomorrow.
Sorry. What is this essay? You convinced me to come and see this movie, but look at what happened. You ruined my day. Oh, no. I'm never coming back here.
Yeah, me please, too. We're really sorry. It's not our fault that we lost power. We apologize, but you can still come back tomorrow. You can still see the ending of the film. You can come back, ma'am.
That's if you can pay your electric bill.
Here's your money.
Oh, my.
I'm sorry. Come back tomorrow. We'll have power by then.
Father, what really happened? Did they cut off our electricity?
This is all my fault. I forgot to pay. Slipped my mind.
Father, will you just please tell me the truth? You told me earlier the theater's beginning to earn some money. It's impossible you just forgot to pay.
Shallow, I used the money to buy.
You used the money to buy me new shoes? Father.
That's a great plan, Mayor.
Am I right?
That will put this town on the map.
Lawrence. Lawrence, come here for a while.
I'll go ahead.
Oh, sure.
Come, son. You remember my only son, Lawrence? Mm. Lawrence, you know everyone. He will inherit all the great things that we are planning here today.
That's why we should do a good job. I want to leave him a progressive Monte Grasha when I retire, when he becomes a new mayor.
Lawrence, your father has so many wonderful plans for Monte Grasha. You know what? He's going to build wider streets, and he wants to expand the airport.
Oh, yes. Son, you remember what we discussed before. I was telling you about building a new mall. Well, finally, the plans are finished, and we're pushing through. Imagine. Monte Grasha will now have a mall of its own. You see? It's going to be great. This province will be progressive by the time you become mayor of this town. And of course, hopefully, by that time, our town will be declared a city.
Well, that's great, Father.
Well, anyway, would you like to look at the plans? You know, you might have some suggestions to improve them.
I still need to do something. Excuse me, everyone.
Okay.
All right. That's my son. As you can tell, he's brilliant. At a young age, he already knows his priorities.
Father, thank you, Father. But no, it's okay. Thank you.
Shallow?
Yes?
I'm really sorry about this.
Father, it's all right. I'm pretty sure we'll get through all this. We'll manage to save this movie house.
I don't know, dear. I try hard every day to fill this movie house with customers. I'm getting tired. It's so difficult. But still, nothing's happening. I can't provide for your needs. Your mother even left us. Maybe your mother's right. I should have sold this place a long time ago.
No, Father. Don't you ever give up. I will help you. We can still make this business grow just like what it was before. Father, please, promise me. Promise me you'll never give up.
Jian, what do you think of my plan to make up with Shallow? Would it work?
Lawrence, I'm not really sure. I haven't tried getting a girl myself. And whenever Shallow's mad or disappointed at me, I just sing her a song.
Maybe we should buy her some flowers or chocolates. Isn't that what girls like? Mm-hmm. Right?
Hey. Hey, looks like, you're planning to court someone. I'm sorry, I overheard you talking about flowers and chocolates. I could only mean one thing. You know, it's easy to court someone. It's very easy to catch a girl's heart. Just make them believe they're the most important people in your lives. And they'll fall for you. Modesty aside, you know, when I was a teenager, I used to be a playboy. I don't want to sound arrogant, but I was great with girls. So, I had several girlfriends back then. So, Lawrence, if you ever need any tips, just come to me.
Father, we're not courting anyone. And in case we do court a girl, she'd be the only one. The girl we're going to marry and love forever. Let's go, Jian.
Excuse me. Shallow, a message from your best friend since childhood.
What is this, Gian? Another one of your games?
Shello, this is serious. Let me finish the song first.
I'm in no mood to fool around with you and that Lawrence, huh?
Essing, I'm so sorry. That's all I can afford.
This is fine. Thank you, Matoy. Thank you.
Oh, by the way, where's Lupe? Has she returned?
Not yet.
I always remember what you said. You told me, if ever I see Lupe, don't stop her at all. But what I don't understand is, why you just let your wife abandon you in Shallow like that? But that's your choice.
I just let her. Because she's confused. I'm giving her time to think and make her own decision. She'll come back soon.
But she's been gone several weeks now, right? This is the longest time she's ever been away. Aren't you going to find her? Aren't you going after her in Manila?
Even if I want to, I can't. Manila is huge. I wouldn't know where to look for her. I can't leave the movie house. And there's no one I can leave my daughter with.
But if you really want to find Lupe, you'll look for her. You'll search everywhere. And Shello's old enough. You can leave her alone. That is unless you feel your movie house is much more important than Lupe.
Honey, please don't be mad. It's just that I've been so busy that I haven't been dropping by. Besides, my son is here. It's risky, and I have a feeling he suspects something. As soon as it's safe, I'll come and visit you. Yeah, yes, Joel. I'll be dropping by the office. Anyway, just cancel all my other appointments. Okay, except the important ones. You be the judge. The priority meetings. You know very well my son's here. And as much as possible, I have a lot of free time, so Frida and I should spend more time with him. Okay? Bye.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, Shello. Lawrence is exerting an effort to make up with you, but you still ignore him. Give him a chance.
I don't care whatever he does. He can do or say anything, but I'm serious. I've had it with him. Tell him that. A slice of chocolate cake, please.
All right.
How much is that?
45.
It's too much. Maybe a banana wrap.
Okay.
I'll have the same thing. Uh-huh. Give me that crispy one.
Where?
Oh, I want that.
Am I really wrong, Lupe? Am I making a choice between you and this movie house? Lupe. 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 I both love you and this movie house. Lupe, I won't be able to bear losing any one of you. Please try to understand. Please come back. Come back to us, Lupe. Your daughter and I need you. You just can't disappear from our lives. Lupe, I love you very much.
Psst.
Can I join you?
I'm done eating.
Shallow. Shallow. Shallow, wait.
What is it that you want from me? Quit following me. Lawrence, I'm a very busy person. I have no time to play games with you.
Shallow, listen.
And what are you doing here? Why'd you come back? Lawrence, I thought you already forgot about us. You've been away for so many years and never even wrote us. And we were so foolish because we kept waiting for a letter. But all the while, you forgot about us already.
Shallow.
But you know, even if you took us for granted, we still treated you as our friend. We made up stupid excuses for you. Maybe you were just busy, maybe life was difficult there. But we said to ourselves, when you come back here, things will be better. We'll all be the same as before. But what happened? You acted like a spoiled brat. You've changed a great deal. You forgot our vows and our dreams in life. And what's worse, you even laughed at them. Huh. To top it all, the worst thing you did to me, you lost my ring. You just threw things which were important to me. So, what do you want from me this time? What?
Here. It's a chocolate cake. I just wanted to give this. Shallow? Shallow, this is delicious.
Will you stop it?
Shallow, wait. Shallow. Don't go, Shallow!